In today's video, we're going to talk all about the most famous Knight Zephyros, Neve Black Talon. Now, you may remember hearing her talked about on this channel before because me and patron Kenzie did an in-depth review on the novel based around her, Black Talon First Mark. But not everyone is interested in the novels per se and prefer these kind of condensed lore bits, and so I'll compile everything we learn about Neve here, and I'll leave a link to that book review in the show notes. It was a pretty interesting read with some really cool narrative beats to it. So again, Neve Black Talon is a Knight Zephyros, and these are the very independent assassins and hunters of Sigmar. She works most closely with the Shadowhammer's Vanguard Chamber, which is part of the Hammers of Sigmar, the golden poster boys, if you will. Now, I hinted at it before, but a Knight Zephyros is a very unique role in kind of the structure of a Stormcast Eternal army. They are extremely independent, and while other units are organized into, regions or battle lines or war fronts, her only job is to kill select individuals, a true assassin. One example in her novel is in the first chapter, killing a Tzeentch wizard. There are tons of Zangor beasts around. She kills some of them, but only as they block her way from her mark, that is, the wizard leader. She dies in that mission to be reforged, but it is considered a success because she took out the wizard with her. In fact, Neve Black Talon is one of the highest regarded Knight Zephyros in Stormcast Eternal, period. One thing I find interesting about this role is how her marks work. Basically what happens is Sigmar appoints an enemy that needs to be eliminated based on whatever criteria he thinks of. From that point on, Neve will feel an indescribable pull towards her target. She intuitively knows right where they are, even in a region she's never visited before. One way to think about this, and kind of an analogy I kind of came up with, is imagine playing you're playing an open world video game. You get a mission and you have a map marker. Even if you've never been there before in the game, it kind of leads you to where you should be, right? You have freedom to go wherever you want, but you always kind of know where you should end up. Now, in combat, Neve prefers to use a pair of hand axes, becoming this like whirling dervish once she closes in on her prey. And this is aided by a unique quirk of the reforging process. As with many Stormcast Eternals, they sometimes pick up or lose abilities after reforging. Well, Neve Black Talon at some point gained the ability to ride the winds etheric, just like Griff Chargers can, meaning that she can traverse immense distances in a short time. And when you combine physical prowess, knowing where her mark is, and being able to ride the wind etheric, she is an incredible predator. Stalking the shadows, lightning speed, pinpoint precision on her target. And it should be noted that she has been reforged quite a bit. Memory loss and personality change are constant worries in her mind, but she keeps those very silent, very inward. Now, in the book Black Talon First Mark, we learn a bit about Neve's life before becoming a Stormcast. The story is told mostly through memory fragments, and it gets clearer towards the end of the book. Right at the beginning of the Age of Chaos, Neve was a small girl living in a very tiny, sort of remote village. Maybe not tiny is the right word, but fairly primitive in terms of kind of barbaric types, but they're good folks. At this point, the armies of Nurgle tear into the region. This particular army led by a champion named Unghold Gotz. And his plague army descended upon Neve's hometown. And they are pretty much extinguished. I mean, the entire village is destroyed and sacked. And at that moment, in the carnage, an alien figure grabs Neve and pulls her away, kind of rescuing her from the whole situation. That alien figure was a branch wraith of the Dreadwood Sylvaneth. And while normally the Dreadwood are openly hostile to outsiders, this particular strand of them had a plan for Neve. And there's a bit of yada 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 in her backstory, but we get the sense that she was trained in the woods to be a warrior by the Sylvaneth, a quick hunter, sharp and deadly. And the ultimate plan was to use Neve as this well-trained soldier to take down Unghold Gotz in the future. And it's certainly a long game plan, but that's kind of what the Sylvaneth do, right? They're long-term thinkers. This would make the Chaos Champion who destroyed her home and her family her first mark, hence the name of the book. In the pursuit of the Nurgle Lord, Neve is struck down, but is taken up in a bolt of lightning. See, Sigmar had seen her efforts, seen all this going on, and wanted to recruit her for the position of a Knight Zephyros. The impression that the Sylvaneth left on Neve carried in her for generations, right? In Black Talon, she meets up with that branch wraith again and learns more. And I'll leave, you know, kind of the spoilers to you in reading the book, or if you want to go follow the link to get it spoiled for you. And so now let's talk about what makes this character cool. It's my favorite part of all these videos, right? With this character, we get a bit of insight into a few things. First of all, what it means to be a Knight Zephyros, because we don't have really any other writings that go into the detail on it, and it's pretty rad. Some of the most independent Stormcasts there are, given an assassination order and the room to do it how they see fit. The idea of Sigmar being like, this guy needs to die, and then dispatching units of these is pretty awesome. The concept of knowing where their mark is at all times is super neat. Like I said before, it's kind of like Sigmar puts on a, you know, quest marker on their map, and they can just figure it out. And the ability to ride the Winds of Theric, it shows up in the book a few times. There's a really cool scene towards the end with it, and they showcase it quite well. Now, in the book, it's described somewhat as being a unique quirk, like as if Neve is pretty much one of the only ones who can do this, or it's some kind of, you know, we would call it a mutation from the reforging process. But, you know, in the War Scrolls, the basic Knight Zephyros can do something similar, so I'm not quite sure in terms of, like, when the book was written versus when the rules were being developed, if it was meant to be super unique to Neve, but in the book, it certainly is. And what makes that unique is that, you know, generally when reforging stuff happens, it's almost always a bad thing. Right, there's memory loss, they can't speak above a whisper, Gardas is one of the few ones who, like, doesn't have a negative trait, he just kind of sparks lightning when he gets mad, but rarely do we see a Stormcast gaining a useful ability. And there's some exceptions, of course, I can think of like two or three, but the novel makes her seem like this unique empowerment of her abilities. And lastly, Neve sheds a little bit of insight into the gods playing with mortals, and here's what I mean. A major theme over the last year and a half has been gods twisting the souls and bodies of mortals to do their will. Sigmar and Nagash have been the main characters to kind of demonstrate this. Well, during her life, Neve was somehow infused with some power of Ghiran, of life. And that remained with her even when Sigmar bolted on Azir magic to kind of reforge her into being a Stormcast, giving her a piece of his divine power. In a sense, she is a character that has been tinkered with more often than most. And this is one of the first books to kind of lean into that idea of the gods tinkering with what mortals are. All of these characters are pawns of the gods in a very direct way. And it's a topic that was later then hammered home in the novel Soul Wars between her mutations and her history with the Sylvaneth and being a Stormcast and being reforged a lot. Neve stands out as a very interesting case study on what being a Stormcast Eternal means. And lastly, she provides a lot of inner dialogue to help us get into their minds. And that's something I've kind of touched on before when I talked about ways to improve Black Library books, is like, let us get inside the head of a Stormcast Eternal. Well, when these visions start appearing to her and memories and that kind of stuff, she feels broken. She feels corrupted. She is hearing changes from reforgings or kind of whispered about the campfire where the Stormcast Eternal set up camp, and it fills her with dread, like, are they going to talk about me like that, like I'm some kind of freak? She also, interestingly enough, refers to the Sacrosanct Chamber, who came out later with Soul Wars, and viewed them almost as a sort of internal inquisition, right? That they were going to find something impure or broken about her, and kind of dismiss her soul, or dismantle it, or whatever that punishment would be. This book and certain scenes really help us understand Neve, but also what it means to be a Hammers of Sigmar and a Stormcast Eternal more broadly. And so, like I said, if this character does interest you more, go ahead and check out our coverage of Black Talon First Mark. It's not so much a book about Stormcast versus, you know, an enemy or something like that. It's really a character study on this one specific character, which you would get from the name, but you would kind of sometimes think it would include a little bit more information. Nope, it's all about Neve. It's all about her backstory. There are also a few short stories that were put on. I believe there's two sequels and one prequel. They're all very short stories available for download. I haven't gotten quite to them yet, but the novel itself really revealed the crux of, like, her backstory in a way that it was interesting, kind of led you along, and the first mark that she had, Unghold Gots, is one of my favorite Nurgle characters there is. But I'm curious as to what y'all think about Neve Blacktalon. She didn't have the huge introduction like some other heroes did, like Vandis Hammerhand. She was just pretty much a support piece brought out in Blight War, the two-player starter box set that had Nurgle and Stormcast in it. And I'm interested to know, how do you think about Neve Blacktalon? Do you think she's important to the lore? Do you think she's kind of a secondary character? Let me know your thoughts in the comments down below, and I will catch you in the next Age of Sigmar lore video. Thank you for watching, and happy wargaming.
Hey Wargamers, Doug here. If you like the show, help the channel grow. Consider becoming one of my patrons over on Patreon. My patrons are vital to help decide the direction of the channel, and patrons of a certain level are automatically entered to win whatever battle tome I just finished reviewing. And I'll ship it anywhere worldwide. But more than that, it's an invitation to be part of a great group that wants to serve the wargaming community as a whole. Click the link in the description down below and you'll be brought over to my Patreon page, which is bursting with helpful information and will answer a lot of questions you may have. For as little as a dollar a month, you can support me and make this channel possible. Thank you all so much for your consideration, and happy wargaming.